we want to multiply the given rational expressions. Notice in these two examples, the numerators and denominators are monomials. In general, to multiply fractions, we multiply the numerators together and then the denominators together. But we do want our product to be in simplest form, and it's much easier to simplify before we multiply rather than after. So to find all the common factors between the numerators and denominators that will simplify to 1, we're going to write everything out in prime factored form. So for 9x squared y, since 9 is equal to 3 times 3, we'll write 3 times 3. And then for x squared, we'd have 2 factors of x, and we have 1 factor of y as well. The denominator is 1 factor of z times 2xz is 2 times x times z. And 3x squared y would be 3 times x times x times y. Now I realize some of us may not have to show all this work, but then when our fractions contain binomials and trinomials, we'll follow the same pattern and write everything out in factored form. So in this form, we can easily identify all the common factors between the numerators and denominators that will simplify to 1. 3 over 3 simplifies to 1. X over x simplifies to 1, x over x, and y over y. And here we have a z over z that simplifies to 1. So now what's left would be our simplified product. Notice in the numerator we have 3 times 2 times x, that would be 6x. The denominator just contains factors of 1. 6x over 1 is just 6x. Let's take a look at a second example. For the prime factorization of 27, 27 is equal to 3 times 9, and 9 is equal to 3 times 3. So we'll have 3 factors of 3 for 27. Mn squared is 1 factor of m and 2 factors of n. 42 is equal to 6 times 7, and 6 is equal to 2 times 3, so we'll have 2 times 3 times 7. Y squared would be 2 factors of y times, here we have 7xy, which is just 7 times x times y. 9 is equal to 3 times 3, so we'll have 3 times 3. M squared is 2 factors of m, and n squared is 2 factors of n. So we have m times n times n. And now we can simplify out all the common factors. 3 over 3 simplifies to 1, 3 over 3 simplifies to 1. Notice how we also have a common factor of m, and we have 2 factors of n common here and here. Here we have 7 over 7 that simplifies to 1, and we have y over y that simplifies to 1. Notice how we also have 3 over 3 here, so this was simplified to 1 as well. Notice in the numerator we just have 1 factor of x left. In the denominator, we have 2 times y times m. I'll put the variables in alphabetical order, so we'll have 2my. This would be our simplified product. Okay, I hope you found these two examples helpful. Next, we'll take a look at when we have binomials and trinomials in the numerators and denominators.